The proper usage of HTTP response codes is very useful when developing REST web services. It's so because a REST web service is based in the HTTP protocol, and each response code has a very important semantic. So we have response codes for indicating the success of a service, and we have response codes to indicate some kind of error, and a lot of kind of errors, including errors in the client, errors in the server, and so on. So in this video, we are going to see how to, when defining a REST web service using the Spring Boot framework, how we can return one specific HTTP response code to our client. Okay, we have already seen in previous videos of this channel that in a Java class that we annotate with REST controller, it becomes automatically one available endpoint to be utilized by the clients of this application, and we can define it endpoint based in the methods that are programmed inside the class, as we have here. In this case, we have mapped this endpoint here, and in this special case, we have two possible parameters that are informed based in the variable path, one for the ID and the other for the first name variable. And these two variables here that are mapped in the request call by the URL, they are going to produce an update statement that will update the first name of a certain entity that has one specific ID. And if this update statement works, if it finds the record with this specific ID, this result variable will have the number of updated entries. So it will be bigger than zero, and then we are going to return the status code OK. It means 200, OK, the success code. And in case it has not found the entity with this ID, it will not update any record, and then it will have the value of zero, and then we are going to return the code 404, indicating the record was not found. Okay, the database we are using is this default MySQL database that comes together when we install MySQL server in our computer. And here we have a lot of entries, and they go until to the ID in my example, 214, right? So any entry from 1 to 214 will be okay, it will work. So if I come here and take the record call saying 214 will have one different name here, for instance, we call that, we got one error. Ah, okay, we already got the error. We got, let me return here, we got the 404 because 2014 we don't have this entry. We have 214, and now we got the success code. So you see, when the entity is found, we return success code. When the entity is not found, so a very bigger code, we return one error code, okay, with this HTTP error. And how we have done that? Basically, we are using this response entity object, and then we return one response entity created with the parameter not found when one error was identified, and we return that with the OK parameter with 200, informing everything was fine. This HTTP status is one enum. It means it has a lot of entries for each of available HTTP return code. So you can just select here the specific code you want. Actually, each of these options is mapped to one integer number that corresponding to the related HTTP response code. And then you select in here the proper option to your context. Then it will return, as we have seen here, that different codes are returned to user. So it's that for this video, showing to you how you can return HTTP response codes according with the semantic of your application. You can download this video based in the link available below at the video description. And thank you for watching.